In this video, we will try to understand how to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam. Now the arrangement of the beam is as shown over here. So we are having a point load of 20 kN acting at the free end and a clockwise moment of 80 kN acting at point B. Now first we'll start with the shear force diagram. So the conventions that we have used for shear force diagram is upward forces, they are considered as positive, whereas downward forces, they are considered as negative. So shear force at A will be equal to minus 20 kN because 20 kN force is acting in the downward direction. Shear force at B will be same as that of A because in between A and B there is no other force that is acting. Similarly, shear force at C is also same because between B and C there is no other point load or UDL that is acting. So we'll first draw the reference line, then the various values at A, B and C. They are nothing but 20 kN, and as we are having the values negative, we have drawn the diagram below the baseline. So all these values are same. So we are getting this particular rectangular type of the diagram over here in case of shear force diagram. Now we'll see how to draw the bending moment diagram in this particular case. The conventions that we have used for bending moment diagram, they are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. So at free end, that is at point A, the bending moment will be zero. Then the important part is just at the left of the B, we have to consider all the forces which are acting on the left hand side of the B. So there is only one force, that is 20 kN, and from A to B the distance is 4 m, so it is producing anti-clockwise moment about point B. So it is minus 20 into 4, that is minus 80 kN. But exactly at B there is a clockwise moment of external moment that is acting and magnitude is 80 kN. So that will get added to this particular minus 80 kN. So minus 80, that is the bending moment just at the left of the B, and this clockwise moment, which is the external clockwise moment, and as it is clockwise it is positive, so minus 80 plus 80, that is zero. So bending moment exactly at point B will be zero. Now bending moment at C, we have to consider all the forces and moment on the left hand side of C. So 20 from A to C, the perpendicular distance is 4 plus 2, that is 6, and this clockwise moment is of 80 kN. So it is minus 20 into 6, that is minus 120 plus 80, that is minus 40 kN. Now we'll draw the bending moment diagram over here. So bending moment at A is 0, at B left it is minus 80, then at B it is 0, and at C it is minus 40. All these values, they are negative, so they are below the reference line. So at A it is 0 kN, at B left it is minus 80 kN, at B it is 0, and at C it is minus 40 kN. So in this way we can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying a point load and the clockwise moment at a certain point B. Thank you very much for watching.